Meanwhile, relief for the families of 9 Australian surfers who are believed to be missing. The Melbourne-born skipper of their boat says they're all safe and had been out at sea when the tsunami struck.
They were the words Hal and Sandra Scurra had been praying they'd hear.
G'day, Dad. How are you? I just said, oh, wow, Chris, you bloody beauty.
A phone call from son Chris, captain of the missing boat, the Southern Cross.
Well, you go through every emotion, tears in the eyes, palpitations, everything, all at the same time, and it's just completely overwhelming.
The skipper had taken his vessel further out to sea after feeling the quake into a phone and radio black spot.
We pulled up the anchor and we motored out into deep water. We didn't experience anything too unusual or radical.
I don't think he'd realised how many people were looking for him and how widespread the search was.
He was very taken with the fact that Kevin Rudd said something about him.
A Blackburn passenger on the boat was just as oblivious. In a text, he described the quake as a bit of a shake.
He rang me, blissfully unaware that anything was going on.
The Scurras are used to Chris being in dangerous situations.
It's not the first time we've had these scares, and it doesn't get any easier.
The lifelong surfer was forced to flee inland after an earthquake last year, and the whole family survived the 2004 tsunami. Hal and Sandra will visit their son in a few weeks' time, but say there's little chance he'll return home.
He's been there for 13 years, and I don't think we're going to change him overnight.
Ben Lewis, 10 News.